بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Great question. Okay, no problem. So Muslims are all one body, right? We have one Lord, one Allah, one Prophet, one nation, one Quran. We're all one, right? In the time of the Prophet, peace be upon him, all the Muslims were together. And then in the first generation, we were together. Then there were some political issues that happened later on. How you doing? How's it going? How's it going? So from that, then it grew to politics, like kind of dividing the people, right? From that, some people became sects, like they broke away from the jama'ah, from the group, right? Take for example, you have Shia, you have Qadiani, you have Ismaili, you have here, like we have the NOI, all these like little groups. But those are not, it's not like there's two different Islams. Those are people that split away. The word Shia means sect.
Okay.
Right? But the majority of the Muslim Ummah, depending on your statistics, 85%, whatever, are one Muslim body, right? Okay. Which people call Sunni, right? Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. So Muslims are one, but there are people who get misguided,
different
right?
Sects.
For example, the Quran you have, like I'll show you something, right? If you don't mind. This is the first chapter. In any Quran you pick up anywhere in the world, you will find the same. It's Surah Al-Fatiha, right? Here it says, it is you who we worship and you who we ask of help.
Right.
So as a Muslim, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. We only ask the unseen help from Allah.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
We don't say, oh Jesus help me, oh Muhammad help me, oh Saint help me, Abdul Qadir, none of that, right? But then you have some people like the Shia, they will say, Ya Ali Madad, oh Ali help us. Mm-hmm. I saw, I don't know if you guys speak Urdu or Farsi or any of that, right? So there was a sign I saw on a cab. It said, Ali, Sher Khuda, Mushkil Kusha. Ali, the lion of Allah, the one who solves your problems. Right? We as Muslims don't believe that. We believe Allah solves all the problems.
Right.
Ali, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, we love them. They're the companions, but we don't worship them. We don't pray to them. We don't pray through them. We worship Allah directly because that's what the Quran says.
Okay.
So the Shia or these groups, they split away. But the Muslim body is one body.
It's one body.
Yeah. And many people here, they used to be on that. And when they got educated, they came back to the real Islam.
The real Islam. Okay. I was so these days in the news, we hear a lot about Afghanistan and the Taliban and their interpretation of Islam.
Is that like a separate sect again?
No. Okay. So first thing, Sharia means law.
Okay.
Oh, right.
Okay.
So Sharia law is like chai tea. Like chai already means tea, right?
Yeah.
Sharia is there's only one Sharia, right? Which is what Allah ordained in the Quran and what the Prophet peace be upon him taught us, right? But then you have political parties. You have Daesh, you have Taliban, you have, you know, whatever. Like in other places, you have different Christian groups, like the Lord's Army, and their ideas and their actions may and may not be in accordance with the Quran,
right?
I personally have a hard time believing everything I read.
Right.
Because I speak to people in other countries, like for example, where are you from originally?
India.
Yeah. Okay. Where in India?
Yeah.
New Delhi.
I've been to Delhi.
Okay.
Right? I was in Nizamuddin area. I've been to Aligarh. I've been to Agra.
Where
been
are
to
you
Bhopal.
Originally from
Peshawar, Pakistan, in the north.
Pakistan.
So I'm ethnically Pashtun. We're from the Afghan area. But I was born in Pakistan and then I was raised here, right? If I look at India from where I have been and what I saw, right? I saw, alhamdulillah, there were Muslims, there were Sikhs, there were Hindus, there were Christians. They all lived together. People bought with each other. It was all good. But if I watch the news, all I see is Modi and I see this and RSS and burning masajid and burning temples. So you see, the news always kind of sensationalizes things, right? If you look at what happens in Afghanistan on the street, it may be different than what we see, right? So I don't pay attention to all that, right? For me, the question is, Islam and the Sharia is one. It's what's in the Quran and what the Prophet ﷺ taught us. Whichever group it may be, if what they're doing is in accordance to that, we accept it. If what they're doing is against that, we reject it.
Right.
I'll give you one little example. Again, like I said, I'm only going off what I saw on the news. So I don't know if that really happened, but I've seen that the Daesh people, they burned a pilot alive. It was a Jordanian Muslim pilot, and they burned him. Now we know the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, in the most authentic book of hadith, from Ali ibn Abi Talib and Ibn Abbas radiyallahu that they said the Rasul, the Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him, forbid punishing anybody with fire. No human should ever light anybody on fire or punish with a fire or brand. Why? Because that right is only with the Lord to punish with hellfire, not us. We cannot do that kind of torture to each other. So any group that does that, that, right? Then their political motives are their political motives, but it's not in accordance to what we see in Islam. I'll give you an example. I don't know what kind of background you come from, right? But you have the Gujarat riot, you have like those kind of things. Many people under the name of Hinduism raped and massacred women, which obviously do not, it's not accordance with Hindu belief. Exactly, exactly. So that's the kind of thing. For me, like, I can't say about any group because I don't know. Like, I'm not there. I don't see what's going on. And politics is politics. If you ever watch Fox and then you watch CNN and MSNBC, you'd think we live in three different countries, right?
Yeah, that's true.
I read sometimes this Russian newspaper, RT, and it's pure Russian propaganda.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But it's so funny because they'll describe Syria totally opposite from what we see here on Fox, right? So the easy thing is, if you want to know about Islam, there you go. Read that, and then that's Islam for you.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
A little water never hurts. Yeah, there's such similarities.
That is so true. Yeah.
Look at the actual.
But see, the Islam kind of explains that, right? Because we as Muslims believe that the same God, the same Allah, same creator that sent Jesus and Moses and Abraham is the one that sent Muhammad. Yep. Peace and blessing be upon them, right? Yep. You see how we love the prophets, right? You never see a Muslim disrespect Moses or David or Jesus. Like, we even meant, when I say their name, I say peace be upon them. That's how much I love them, right? Every one of us Muslims has to believe in Jesus as a prophet, but we have to believe in Jesus. If we don't believe in Jesus, we're not Muslims. Peace and blessings be upon him, right? And that's why if you look at the base of the Ten Commandments, like don't worship idols, don't worship other gods, don't false deities, you know, don't kill, don't sin, all of that you'll find in Islam as well, right?
Right, and that's what I love that, and you know, it's nice to compare.
There are more similarities than, and think of it this way, right? Like, if you look at Judaism, they will say Jesus was not a prophet, he was not God, he was not the son of God, he was, I mean, they use very, you know, disrespectful terms to being born out of wedlock and things like this. Right. Muslims never. We believe in the virgin birth. We believe that Mary was not touched by a man. Allah ordered it, and as Adam and Eve and others before were born without fathers and without mothers, Jesus was born without a father, the order of Allah, right? We have that similarity with Christians, right? Now, with Jews also, and a lot of things about their monotheism, Islam has a lot of things that are very similar, right? But people use these things for politics. Like, people use kind of to divide people and to make them fight. It's all politics, right? But for us, we say, look, I'm sure you've studied the Bible. I can tell you're a well-read man. You've studied Gita. You've studied probably Buddhist texts, I'm assuming. You're all over, right? One thing you will find unique about the Quran is you will first not find any contradictions, right? You will not find numeric contradictions, as you will find in the Old Testament and the New Testament, where obviously because you have scribes that are human, that are giving accounts that are not purely the words of God, they're the works of men. Whether they're divinely inspired or not is a different issue, but they're going to make mistakes, right? Somebody's going to say the crow.
They copied back then, and sometimes, we need to add that.
You are on. That you're.
My dad.
Your dad is a smart man, man.
He is, man.
He knows his stuff. And that's the amazing thing about the Quran, that we memorize it word by word, letter by letter, right? You can pick a chapter. I can have one of these brothers read it from their memory, right? So that way we don't have these kind of copyist errors. We have manuscripts that can be carbon dated, certain pages to the life of the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, certain the entire manuscripts to the life of the companions, the first generation that compiled them, right? So that's why every Muslim has one Quran. As you know, if you go get a Catholic Bible, the original, I mean, you'll find, especially in the Old Testament, different number of chapters. Book of Mormon's a whole different book, right? Then between the Jehovah's Witnesses and the Christian Bible, you'll find different verses. I have the New World Translation from that. Quran, alhamdulillah, only one Quran. There's different recitations, but there's only one Quran. Even if you go to the Rafidah, the Shia, even if you go to some sects, 114 chapters, begins with Al-Fatiha, ends with Nas. Right? 30 sections, right? And that's something you'll find unique about the Quran. Right? Islam is not named after any man. Like Christianity, after Christ. Buddhism, Buddha. Confucianism, Confucius. Islam, not Muhammadans. Right? Look at us. Because we believe we're on the same religion that Moses and Abraham and Jesus were upon. Peace and blessings be upon them. We worship the same creator that Moses and Abraham and Noah and Jesus and Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon them, worship, right? So we're trying to unite upon the truth. There you go. Man, you're a Muslim, I'm telling you, man. You're just hiding it for now. It's all right, man. We'll give you some time. Let me know.
Blessings to you.
Blessings to you, and have a blessed day. May Allah bless you with guidance and bless me with it. and keep us safe and keep us upon the truth. Thank you so much. If you have any other questions, come back.
Thank you.
I'm looking forward to talking to you more. You're a good man. Benefit from your father.
Thank you.
Have a good one.
حمدا لمن هداني لسنة العدنان محمد المختار وسيد الأطهار.
الأرجوزة السنية في سيرة خير البرية نظمها الشيخ الأمين موافق أداء صخر ابن شيخ رشاد.